Welcome back. It's time now for our Health Network Update Report. Health reporter Lino Mudu is here with a warning about buying drugs via the internet. Hello, Lino.
Hello, Vincent. Hello, everyone. Well, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration is warning consumers that the vast majority of internet pharmacies are fraudulent and are likely selling counterfeit drugs that could harm or kill them. The agency recently launched a national campaign called Be Safe RX to alert the public to the danger as more people are shopping online for their medicine. Internet consumers are more likely to get fake drugs that are contaminated past their expiration date or contain no active ingredient. Some of the counterfeit drugs even contain toxic substances such as arsenic and rat poison. Fake drugs can also cause people to develop a resistance to the real medicine, develop harmful new side effects, or trigger harmful interactions with other medications they may be taking. The World Bank here in Washington recently held a discussion on the issue of counterfeit medicines. The workshop aimed to help medical professionals and others to better understand the global phenomenon of counterfeit medicines and explore possible solutions. Interpol estimates that 30% of medicines circulating in Africa are either counterfeit or of inferior quality. Experts say there is no reliable data on the scope of the problem. Participants at the conference agreed on the need for more awareness about the harmful effects of counterfeit medicines. Dr. Patrick Lukule with the U.S. Pharmacopeial Convention was one of the conference panelists.
The problem really is ignorance about the problem. And so people have not really understood what the hurtful effects of having bad products can be on your health. Even now, in certain developing countries, if a product looks like a pill, they just assume this must be a good pill. And so the knowledge base about what pharmaceutical products constitute and the type of harm they could cause, people have not really been paying a lot of attention to it. So we are now slowly, gradually educating the population about pharmaceuticals as a special class of commodities, and these should be treated as such.
And Michael Dietz, a technical officer with the World Health Organization, says counterfeit medicine is a difficult problem to tackle for a variety of reasons.
Well, one of the aspects you must remember is that those involved in falsifying medicines falsify them with a view that they won't be detected. Visual examination of some of these medicines won't determine that they are in fact falsified products. The other factor is that those involved in the manufacture and distribution of these types of medicines, what they want to do is create profit, gain money, make money in a low-risk manner, and also difficult to detect it if it causes a problem with a patient. You must remember that the patient's on the medicine because they're ill in the first place. If a patient should go back to their doctor and say that either their medicine's not working or they're not feeling well, it's unlikely that a healthcare professional will immediately think that there's something wrong with the medicine or it's falsified because the patient is ill in the first place. All of those things make it difficult to detect.
And joining us for more discussion on counterfeit drugs is Dr. Patrick Lukule, Vice President of Global Health Impact Programs with the U.S. Pharmacopeial Convention. Dr. Lukule is also Director of USAID-funded PQM program. Dr. Lukule, welcome to the program.
It's a pleasure, Lina, to be with you.
Before we talk about fake drugs, let's talk about a good drug. What makes a good drug?
A good pharmaceutical product has to have certain quality attributes, and these attributes range from the active ingredient has to be the right chemical entity. It also has to have the right amount, what we call the assay, which is the amount of active ingredient that should be in the drug. Also, the dissolution profile is important. How quickly does the drug dissolve when it's taken into the GI tract? These are all characteristics that constitute what we call a good medicine.
So what are we seeing with the fake medicine? What are some of the problems with them?
So with fake medicines, these are generally medicines that masquerade to be good medicines, but they are not. They either have the wrong active ingredient, or they don't have the amount in the right quantity necessary for therapeutic effect, or they have poor dissolution, meaning when you take it into the system, it does not release its content. And all these would are very bad for the patient, and they would lead to the drug not being effective.
Now, tell us how significant this problem is. You know, some experts say we cannot really assess the problem globally, but do you have an idea?
It is a serious problem, and it's really undermining health programs, particularly in developing countries, because you have certain situations where the number of counterfeit or substandard medicines is as high as 25 to 30%. We have done some studies in Africa where we have uncovered several counterfeit anti-malarials and counterfeit antibiotics in very large proportions. More disturbing is the presence of these products in public sectors. It's not only limited to private sector, but we do find them even in public facilities, and this is really damning.
So what is the problem here? Is it the fact that maybe there are not good regulations to really see this problem, or maybe is it because these regulations are there, but they are not being enforced?
Yes, it's both. Most developing countries have poor regulatory regimes. You don't have good oversight of the market, and so medicines that are making in are medicines that should never be registered. In certain cases, the regulators don't even have the opportunity to see these medicines come through because of the porous nature of the borders in these countries. They make it through several avenues, and the regulators are not even aware.
So today, what is available out there to really tackle this issue? I've seen that new technology is being used. In Ghana, for example, they have introduced the MP degree. Is that the solution?
That's one of the solutions. It's really a multifaceted solution. You have to use policy backed with good law. There has to be a good legislative platform so that the regulators have a way of enforcing these laws. Also technology, which you mentioned, there are various technologies that are being used to go at this problem, and they vary from the use of pedigree to using field-based screening technologies and laboratory-based technologies. But also an important aspect of the fight against counterfeit also has to include the need to educate the patient. People should recognize and know where to buy good medicines. You cannot just afford to go in any back alley and buy medicine from peddlers. You have to go to legitimate markets in order to obtain your product.
Okay, Dr. Lukule, thank you so much.
It's a pleasure to be with you. Thank you.
And that was Dr. Patrick Lukule, Vice President of Global Health Impact Programs with the U.S. Pharmacopeial Convention. And that's our Africa Health Network report for today. For more health news and developments, be sure to visit our website at africahealthnetwork.com. Vincent?
Well, thanks a lot, Lino. Be sure to watch for Lino Mudu's Africa Health Network reports every Tuesday and Thursday right here on In Focus.